120 Minutes. I'm Dave Holmes. I'm here with Liz Phair. Welcome to 120
Thank
Minutes.
Thank you so
I'm
much.
I'm so pleased to meet you. And I'm addicted to the new album, White Chocolate Space Egg.
I think it's fantastic.
So amazing. And it's so different from the first two.
Yeah, I was kind of more experimental musically this time. Kind of saw it in like dramatic soundscapes each song.
Yeah. And lyrically, it's very different. And you've had a, you know, the past 4 years have been very busy for you. You got married, had a kid.
Yeah.
Has that affected the way you write songs?
I think so. I think anything you go through in life does, because songwriting comes from such a like deep place, personal place for me, that like whatever I go through, I kind of see my albums as timepieces for like, you know, almost like references for what I was then, you know, like what I did in my 20s, what I did in my 30s.
Right.
Yeah.
How does the husband feel about the new album? Is there some
he likes it. He likes it a lot.
Yeah.
He didn't get that involved in my music though.
Really?
Which is kind of a good thing. He kind of steers clear of that whole thing.
Right. Did you feel pressure to do another Exile in Godville with this record? Do you?
No, I didn't feel that at all. I think the only time that was even in my consciousness was after I made it and people were comparing the two, because naturally fans of the earlier stuff want to know just where you're going and like whether they're going to come along with you.
Mm-hmm.
And to me it was really this great opportunity to kind of create something anew, to really like stretch my legs, so to speak, and like do something different, because I really wanted to be experimental this time and be a little more free and not burdened by what I was supposed to do or what I was, you know.
Right. Well, it's fantastic, and we're going to check out the latest video right now.
Polyester Bride.
From the album White Chocolate Space Egg. We'll talk about the making of this video later. Here's Polyester Bride, 120 Minutes. Hi, I'm Dave Holmes here, hanging out with Liz Phair, talking about dirty ads and whatnot. Don't you wish you could be here during these breaks? Anyway, we just saw your video a few back for Polyester Bride.
That's right.
What do you think of making videos? Do you like it?
I love making videos. It's like my favorite part, because it's really like a way I can kind of get across like the visual. Like you can really understand a song so much better when you see a video. You can really get the impact of what you're trying to say with it out to people.
Right.
And it's just a
exciting moment. And you directed quite a few.
I directed a lot of my videos, yeah, which was a gap.
Which ones did you direct?
Which do I like the best? I mean, Supernova was a big favorite of mine.
Supernova is such a great video. It's fantastic.
A lot of people really liked the part where I'm wearing the little helmet and kicking my leg.
Yeah.
Oh, and God, I had to work so hard to get the guys in the band to do the trampoline. I mean, it took a lot of cajoling, because Brad and Casey were like,
Yeah.
No. And then by the time we're on the trampoline, because all those, you see the footage of us flying around.
Yeah.
Like, you couldn't get them off. Like, they were starting to get their, you know, sportsmanship up, and they're like,
right.
Brad especially was like doing karate kicks and stuff, or Casey was, and it was really cool.
Yeah, I like the little, like,
see, videos are like an opportunity to do cool things, like run around on the streets and like talking walkie-talkies, and like,
yeah,
it's like really active, and I love that about
theatric
stuff. Yeah,
right.
Who doesn't want to do that?
Right on. We will be back. We will have more with Liz Phair in the future, but right now let's check out the top 10 singles and alternative music this week. We're checking out Supernova. That is what all videos should be.
Oh, God. I'm so glad you just played that and I got to see it, because I haven't seen it in so long.
Bringing back
memories. How much fun was that?
Of the old days.
It was such a great video to shoot, too. We had such a gas doing it.
Yeah. Everyone else out there, watch that video and learn from it. Every video should be.
You got to get a crew in there. You got to do some rowing. You got to get, like, ghosts and,
the
like,
whole bit. Haunted house.
Yeah, haunted
sexy
house.
Looks, like, off camera.
Yeah, yeah. I was looking at that makeup, and I did my own makeup.
Learn. Watch and learn, artist.
Watch and learn.
Now, you're out on tour right now, and you did some Lilith dates over the summer.
Oh, yeah.
How was
that
for you?
That was awesome. I love doing Lilith Phair. It was one of the, I think of it as like a pivotal moment in my career, because it was really when I decided that playing live was going to be something that I was going to love and get better at and really kind of like get into. Like, accepted my performerism this summer, because I met so many women and I was so impressed with them. And I learned so much just watching their shows. And it kind of gave me more confidence, because I could relate to them backstage and as people, and they were so nice to me. Right. And then on stage, I would see what they would do, and they just had the house. I mean, right. They had 20,000 people in the palm of their hand.
Right.
And I thought, you know, these are my peers. I might be a freshman, and they're seniors, but, like, yeah. These are my peers. And I felt really inspired.
That's great. Because you didn't tour behind Whip Smart, and now you
No,
are.
I used to hate playing live.
Yeah, I'm so glad you're back. Was there anybody on Lilith that you had to be out in the audience to see?
I always walked out to see Sarah's show. I always walked into the audience to really see Sarah's show because it was so impressive.
She's amazing.
I watched everybody's show from backstage, though. I watched everybody's show almost every night.
That's great.
Yeah.
We still have more to talk about with Liz Phair. There are some things I want to know. But right now, we're going to check out a debut video from Lenny Kravitz. You a Lenny Kravitz fan?
Oh, love this guy. I met him in the Bahamas once.
Did you really?
There was a big rainbow.
Yeah.
He'd remember this. It was like a really intense rainbow.
It's very symbolic.
Was
he like right at the end of it?
He's a wonderful person.
Yeah. Well, this is his new video. It's Fly Away.
It's a debut.
On our 20 minutes. That was Liz Phair with the title track to his second album, Whip Smart. We're just chatting away.
I know.
We come back way too quick. I am Dave Holmes. When 120 Minutes returns, we're going to be talking more with Liz Phair. We're just going to keep talking, but you're not going to see most of it. And we're going to check out a new video from the John Spencer
Which
Blues
is
Explosion.
So cool. I just watched it.
Liz
it's amazing.
Is a big fan of this video, and I'm sure you will be too. So don't move.
Don't even breathe.
Back to 120 Minutes. I'm Dave Holmes. I'm still here with Liz Phair. Just checked out a little Stratford-on-Guy from the great Exile on Guyville album. Which
can I tell you a little something about that really
please.
Quick? That was one of those great rock and roll experiences because I was backstage at a show, and this is before I was really like a viable artist in any way.
Yeah.
And Danny Goldberg was president of Atlantic at the time. And we were talking about this video, and I'm like, I need a jet. And it was like one of those things you like think about rock and roll. He was like, you need a jet? Ting. And I had a jet. I had like a Learjet for a day to film my stupid like $5,000 video.
Yeah.
And we were up like over LA with so much G-force. This guy was like turning over the downtown. People were getting sick. And the cameraman was a friend of ours. And he was like holding this 35-pound camera. Like the whole plane was angled right over Los Angeles. It was a cool rock and roll moment.
That's amazing. And Danny Goldberg has a wand.
He had a wand. You need a jet? Ting. You got a jet.
Man. See, I'm so glad I work in the music industry. I guess the magic
does happen. Not often, but it does happen.
Yeah. I just want to talk about Exile and Guyville for a moment. I hope you're not sick of talking about
this. I'm not sick of talking about it.
Okay, good. How much of that was really you, and how much of it was sort of like a fantasy, like something that you wanted to project?
I always mix the two in my songs because it's really important that it come from authentic feelings, and those feelings stem from a real experience that I've had. But what you find in songwriting is that if you really want to convey that in 3 minutes with like 5 sentences so that someone else can feel what you felt like, and that's my big motivating thing, feel what I felt like, go through it like I did, then you have to kind of like create this environment, like maybe exaggerate circumstances or make it more intense in a way. Or I have a huge imagination. I have a whole career because I have a big imagination.
Yeah.
So I really like to mix and match when it comes to, and it keeps, you know, it exciting for me, and it keeps people guessing, you know.
Do you find that people expect you to be this really sexually frank, very forward person because of that?
Yeah, they do. And in some ways I am.
Right.
And in some ways that's also my outlet for being more daring than I am, and my outlet for being like something I'm not, and that's part of what the big gas is for me, so I need that.
Yeah.
And so it's kind of a little bit of both.
Okay.
And I like that.
I'm addicted to that album and to the new one as well. We're going to check out a little John Spencer Blues Explosion, but don't forget, pick up White Chocolate Space Egg. You'll be glad you did. And her two earlier albums, Whip Smart and Exile and Guyville. Right now, we're going to check out this John Spencer Blues Explosion thing. You love this video, right?
Just saw it. It's awesome.
Yeah. It's got a few celebrity cameos. Are you, do you hang out with John Spencer and the gang? They're label mates, right?
No, I've never met him.
You never have, really?
No.
Neither have I.
But I've met Winona.
That's right. That's right. She just met Winona. Let's
Cha-ching.
Go find. Let's find John Spencer.
Okay, let's go find him.
Cool. I'll start the car. All right, go get the album Acme. It will be available to you tomorrow, October 20th. It's the new one. This is Talk About the Blues. Thank you, Liz. for coming.
Thank you so much for having me.
John Spencer.